If you have a turntable or cassette deck and its motor sounds like this, or like this, then you may be able to get it to be as quiet as this. Just by adding a single drop of oil to the motor.
This is a problem I've noticed a lot with turntables and cassette decks which use these DC servo motors that kind of look like they're in a tin can. And they usually have one or two holes in the back for adjusting the speed. These are very common motors and they can work very well, but the problem is, especially the cheaper turntables and record players and cassette decks, they're cheapening out on these motors and they're giving you ones that don't have any oil inside them to lubricate them. With turntables is especially bad because that noise and vibration from the motor can travel through the platter and get picked up by the stylus, producing a buzzing sound in the audio. You would think these would be permanently lubricated at the factory because it's a sealed can. You're not supposed to open it up and add oil like with a fan motor or an old-fashioned AC motor. But I've encountered so many of these that have been noisy, I started investigating the problem. So I opened up one of these and I discovered there's no oil or any kind of lubrication inside these things. And just adding one drop of oil to them is all it takes to really quiet these things down and smooth them out so that the noise and vibration is no longer a problem. The first device I fixed with this technique of oiling the motor is this very strange looking slot loading cassette player, because when I first got it, it had very bad flutter in the audio, and it's not the belt's fault. The belt was actually perfectly fine. So I took apart the motor and oiled it, put it back in, and now this thing plays perfectly. Note that this is not a guaranteed fix. It could possibly be that your motor is just bad and needs to be replaced. And also, this is not for a novice, because these things are really not meant for you to take apart, and it's possible to break them. So you have to be careful, and this is not for a beginner. But I practiced with this motor here, just a spare motor I had on hand. First thing you're going to do is pry off this cover, which is usually pretty easy to do. You just take a flat blade screwdriver and wedge it between this part of where the circuit board sticks out and covers a little gap there. You can just stick it in and it comes flying off. Obviously this is going to be the easiest to do if the motor is completely removed from whatever device it's inside of, or at least if you have good access to it. So after you pry it off the cover, you want to pry out this circuit board assembly. Now you don't want to get too rough on this because it's possible to crack and break the circuit board. If you're lucky, you may be able to just pop out the whole thing like that. But on some of these, I've had to pry it out, but this one's pretty loose already, so I can just pop it out. Now you have to be especially careful here if these little metal fingers, they're very delicate, so you got to be very careful. And the object is to get a drop of oil into that little recess down there, because that's where these things never had any oil from the factory. Because that's where the end of the motor shaft goes into. And it's basically just metal into plastic with no kind of lubrication. And that's why these things are so noisy. But I found that just putting a little tiny drop of oil into there and putting it back together really helps to quiet these motors down. So what I've used is ordinary 3-in-1 oil. You can get it at any hardware store. But the tip on this spout is still too big to get into this little hole here. So if you have a syringe, you can use that. I found this little squeeze bottle with a very small tip on the end, and I'm going to use that to draw some oil into this and then drop it down into that hole there. So I'm just going to put some oil into this bottle cap, get it into this squeeze bottle. That should be more than enough. Because all we want is just one drop of oil. Even that's probably more than enough. So, try to get the excess off of this tip. Get the drop of oil down into that cavity. Boop! Went in, and that little drop of oil should be all we need. So now to reassemble the motor. Pop. That's back together. Well, if these motors that have these adjustment holes in the back, as most of them do, in order to help you line up the cover, what I'm going to do is just mark where those holes are with a magic marker on the edge so I can line it up better. This thing doesn't really matter because you can just stick your screwdriver right through it when you're adjusting the motor, but in case you've already done that, you can kind of see where it's already been poked through, and you can line that up with those adjusters in there. And most of these covers, you can see markings indicating the pinout of the terminals, so that helps you get a rough idea of how to line it up. That looks like it's pretty well lined up. And you can squeeze it, but in order to get it fully back into place, that's where I take a pair of pliers and give it the final squeeze. And that should be good to go. Now this is obviously just a practice run. Now I'm going to do it for real on one of my cassette decks. It's an Ion tape to PC, just a very cheap low-end cassette deck. I got this at a thrift store a couple years ago, but it appeared to be unused because it still had the original plastic wrap on the power cord. And when I first started using this, I noticed both of the motors for each deck are pretty noisy, but especially this deck was a lot more noisy than this side. So yesterday I just did that trick of putting a single drop of oil in the motor, and now this motor is whisper quiet. Won't even be able to hear it on video. Well, this one is still pretty noisy. Maybe you can just about hear it rattling and grinding away. Maybe now you can hear the difference better. This is the motor that still needs to be oiled. Well, this is the motor I oiled yesterday. Probably can't even hear that. So today I'm going to remove this motor and put that drop of oil in it. And in addition to just quieting this thing down and making it sound better, it may actually help improve this deck's performance, because when I did that on this motor, I measured the wow and flutter and speed before and after I oiled it, and it did make a slight improvement in the wow and flutter, and also I noticed the speed increased a little bit because of the reduced friction inside the motor. Luckily there are trimmers to adjust the motor speed on the circuit board here, so I was able to compensate for that. Now if I was feeling brave, I might attempt to do this with the motor still inside the cassette deck, but they're easy enough to remove that I'll do it anyway, just to gain better access to it. All I need is a small Phillips screwdriver to hopefully remove this screw holding it in place, which may take some convincing. Okay, JIS screwdriver to the rescue. Just as I figured, it does not use Phillips screws, it uses JIS screws. I made a video about the difference and why you need JIS screwdrivers if you work on electronics. So instead of potentially stripping the screw using a Phillips screwdriver, I switched to a JIS screwdriver, and that was able to get it loose. So that is that screw removed, and now very easy to remove this motor. You just slide it to the left slightly, and there it goes. And now I have somewhat better access to this motor, and I'm going to try to pop off that cover. There we go. So there's the cover, and there's the foam gasket. Needs a little bit of prying to get off. On this one, this adjustment hole does nothing because there is no adjustment in the motor. It's done on the circuit board. So in this case,
I don't really have to worry about lining it up exactly when I go to put it back in. What worked for me is taking this spudger tool with a little hook on the end and prying it underneath the edge of the circuit board there, which did manage to pop it up slightly. Wiggle it. That works. There we go. Again, you want to be very careful not to bend any of those metal fingers. And we just want to get a very tiny drop of oil down into there. Boom. Now to carefully reassemble it. There we go. Snapped into place. Now I'm going to turn it on, make sure it still works. Yep. It's spinning. I don't know if you can see that on video, but it's spinning. Now to just put the cover back on. And squeeze it into place. Reinstalling the belt. You see how thin the belts are on this thing? It's ridiculous. They could make this deck a lot better just by giving it slightly better belts. So I got the belt reattached to the flywheel. Now I want to hook it onto the motor. There's two grooves on the pulley. You want to get on this one, at least on the inner one. I think the outer one would be for if this was a double cassette deck with one motor for both decks. But this uses separate motors for each deck, so it hooks onto the groove that's closer to the motor itself. So the belt is back on, and now just to get the motor back into place and reinstall this screw. I think we're good to go. Just a quick check to make sure it's working. Hit play. Yep. Fast forward. Rewind. Alright, you can tell it's quieter than it was before. You probably can't even hear that now. And just as I suspected, oiling the motor did improve its performance, because before I oiled it, the wow and flutter was between 0.09 and 0.10. Now it's between 0.07 and 0.08. So just like the other deck I oiled, it did make a small but noticeable improvement in the wow and flutter. And all things considered, that's actually pretty damn good for one of these cheap Tanishin mechanisms. And the speed is almost exactly perfect. I did not need to adjust that. It's supposed to be 3000, it's 2998.6. So that's perfectly acceptable. But like I said, this is a delicate procedure. Do not attempt this if you don't have the necessary tools and skill. And I definitely recommend practicing on a spare motor before you do it for real on a tape deck or turntable you care about. Get one of these on eBay. They only cost a couple bucks. And practice on a spare motor before you do it for real. Eventually I'll do a full review of this cassette deck, which will apply to a whole slew of different brands and models. I think at last count there's like 8 or 9 different brands this same deck is sold under. But for now I'll leave you with a sample of a recording I made onto Sony HF Type 1 tape, with a nice big chunk taken out of the side there. I recorded this from CD on the B deck after I oiled its motor. But I'll play it back on this side to demonstrate the performance of it after oiling its motor.
I'm all for you, body and soul. I can't believe it, it's hard to conceive it, that you turn away romance. Are you pretending? It looks like the ending.